Every city in the world has a statue that reflects a time in their history or tells an interesting tale, but they're not nearly as famous as these. Let's go globetrotting and find out more about the most famous statues in the world. The Thinker by Auguste Rodin. When you think of The Thinker, you do not think that it's from a comedy, maybe not a comedy you are thinking about, but the Divine Comedy, written by Dante. The Thinker was meant to be a representation of one of the characters from the work by Dante, some even believing it to be Dante himself, standing at the gates of hell. The sculpture is made of bronze and designed by Auguste Rodin. The Thinker represents philosophy, but was originally called The Poet. It was part of his works called The Gates of Hell, commissioned in 1880. In the original work, The Thinker is surrounded by several smaller figures. There are 28 of these placed in public spaces and museums globally. Little Mermaid, Denmark. This might be the perfect place to spot Ariel, as the Little Mermaid sits quietly on a rock in the harbor, north of Copenhagen's Old Town, where it is easily accessible by foot. The original fairy tale of the Little Mermaid was written by Danish author Hans Christian Andersen. The bronze statue was designed by Edvard Eriksen. The statue stands 4.1 feet or 1.25 meters tall and is 385 pounds or 175 kgs in weight. The statue was commissioned by Carl Jacobsen, the founder of Carlsberg Brewery, and was unveiled in 1913. He went to watch the ballet of The Little Mermaid and loved it so much that he had to leave her legacy behind in Copenhagen. Venus de Milo, France. Imagine being the Greek goddess of love, yet having no arms. Kind of hard to hug anybody without arms. The Venus de Milo, or Aphrodite, is a marble structure meant to depict the Greek goddess of love and beauty, Aphrodite, or Venus to the Romans. The statue was created by Alexandros of Antioch between 130 and 100 BC. The large statue stands at 6.8 feet tall, or 2.07 meters, and currently stands in the Louvre in Paris, France. It was found on the Greek island of Milos, after which it was named. Unfortunately, part of her hand and plinth was lost after the discovery. The missing arms of the goddess are an intrigue to both historians and visitors, and many have speculated as to why they're missing. Maybe Disney was correct when they depicted Hercules skipping a stone and accidentally breaking them off. Christ the Redeemer, Rio de Janeiro. With his arms wide open, welcoming all in Rio de Janeiro, Christ the Redeemer statue overlooks the city on top of the 2,300-foot or 700-meter peak of the Corcovado Mountain in the Tijuca Forest National Park. The construction happened between 1922 and 1931, and the statue was made with concrete and soapstone. With a weight of 635 metric tons, the statue stands tall at 98 feet or 30 meters, excluding its 26-foot or 8-meter pedestal, with his arms outstretched at 92 feet or 28 meters wide. The statue stands as a symbol of Christianity around the world, as well as one of the most prominent tourist attractions for Brazil and South America. As a bonus FYI, the original design of the statue was quite different. Christ was meant to be holding a globe in his one hand and a cross in the other, as opposed to the wide open arms. David statue, Italy. The statue of David stands in all his glory in Firenze, Italy. This fine Renaissance-era statue, sculpted out of marble by Michelangelo, is a perfect glimpse into the past. The 17 feet or 5.17 meter tall statue was sculpted between 1501 and 1504 and was meant to be part of a series of commissions of statues of prophets. But once David was completed, it was moved to a public square outside the Palazzo Vecchio. The left foot of David has been damaged over the years because of exposure to the elements, as well as a man in 1991 who took a hammer to the foot. Spring Temple Buddha, China. The Spring Temple, now the second tallest sculpture in the world, was constructed at Lushan County, Henan, China, between 1997 and 2008. Representing the Lord Buddha, it stands at 420 feet or 128 meters and is made of copper. The Buddha stands on an 82 feet or 25 meter lotus pedestal, which also has a monastery on the inside. The Buddha is made up of an estimated 100 kilograms of gold, 3,300 tons of copper alloy, and roughly 1,500 tons of steel. The Spring Temple gets its name from the Tain Rui Hot Springs, and the pedestal stands on two structures, the diamond and the Sumeru seat, further enhancing the height of this behemoth of a statue. Terrace of the Lions, Delos, Greece. Look at these sculptures just lying around. The Terrace of the Lions in Delos, Greece has been around since 600 BC, Delos being the birthplace of the famed Greek god Apollo. It is believed that the people of Naxos built these 12 lions to honor Apollo. The archaeological site on Delos is incredible, the Terrace of the Lions being the most popular feature. Unfortunately, at the site itself, they only have the replicas, as the originals have been moved to a nearby museum for fear of them being damaged over the years by weather and climate change. Statue of Liberty, New York, United States. Give me your tired, your poor. This was part of a poem that was written in 1883 to help raise funds for a pedestal to perch the Statue of Liberty on. Lady Liberty looked much different in those years, as she was still copper in color. This beautiful statue was dedicated to the United States on 28 October 1886 by the people of France. The statue is an icon of freedom, and it was given to celebrate the 100th anniversary of the signing of the Declaration of Independence. This 305-foot or 93-meter tall statue from base to tip is shown to be walking, showing the moving forward after abolishment of slavery. The Great Sphinx of Giza, Egypt. Nobody knows exactly who removed the nose from the Great Sphinx, but speculations include that Napoleon shot it off in 1798, but many believe that it was done in the 15th century already. The Sphinx of Giza is one of the biggest mysteries of the world. Historians tend to disagree with the history of it or who actually built her, but what is certain, the Sphinx is an incredible sight. Said to be modeled on the pharaoh Khafre, the monumental limestone structure faces west to east. With its body of a lion and a head of a human, the statue is 66 feet or 20 meters tall, 63 feet or 19 meters wide, and 241 feet or 73 meters long, and sits on the Giza Plateau on the west bank of the Nile River in Giza. The most common theory of its construction was that it was built during the time of the Old Kingdom by ancient Egyptians around 2508 and 2532 BC. The Mannequin Piss, Belgium. Now, this is quite a relieving statue. This little rebellious mascot of Brussels is a small bronze statue of a baby boy taking a leak into a water basin. Definitely something we have all seen at least once. Installed in the 17th century, this statue, standing at 24 inches or just 61 centimeters, has played an important role in the distribution of drinking water to its citizens. During specific traditions and events, Mannequin Piss is dressed up in different costumes and is definitely a sight to see. The Motherland Calls, Volgograd, Russia. The Motherland Calls in Volgograd is a beautiful 279 feet or 85 meter tall statue commemorating the Battle of Stalingrad. Completed in 1967, the significant statue is more complex than it seems due to the posture and the sword raised above her head. The Motherland is the tallest statue of a woman in the world, excluding its plinth, and tallest in Europe. There are 200 steps leading from the bottom of the hill up to the monument to symbolize the 200 days of the battle. Olmec Colossal Heads, Mexico. A head above the rest, the first colossal head being discovered in 1862 was said to come from the Olmec, an ancient pre-Columbian civilization. The civilization being most prevalent during 1400 BC to 400 BC was said to have carved these massive statues, varying in size from 3.8 feet to 12 feet or 1.17 meters to 3.8 meters. Each head is unique, adorned with various headdresses used for either ceremonial purposes or a Mesoamerican ball game. The Statue of Unity, India. This is the tallest statue in the world, and it stands along the Narmada River in India. At an eye-watering height of 597 feet or 182 meters, the statue was inaugurated on the 31st of October 2018. The statue represents the 143rd birth anniversary of Sardar Patel. He was the first Home Minister of India. He was known for uniting India, 562 states in fact, until the partition in 1947. The statue took 3,000 workers over 3 years to construct, and its outer layer is made of bronze. So, over the next 100 years, the color will start going green through oxidization. It weighs 2,000 tons and was designed by Ram V. Sutar. Lincoln Memorial, Washington, D.C. As he sits looking over the reflecting pool ahead of him, Abraham Lincoln is in a state of contemplation. This 19-foot or 5.8-meter marble statue attracts about 6 million visitors each year. Constructed in 1914 and unveiled in 1922, this tribute to the man who ended slavery in the USA is fitting. There are a few urban legends surrounding this famous statue, including that the face of Robert E. Lee is carved on the back of the head of Abraham Lincoln. How many of these famous statues have you seen in real life? We'd love to hear from you in the comments below. 1. Maui, Easter Island. Now, this is a head-scratcher. The Maui statues on Easter Island have been a mystery for years. Discovered in 1722, on Easter Sunday, where the island got its name, Jacob Roggeveen, a Dutch explorer, landed on this island. They were shocked to find these massive stone carvings, known as Maui, around the island. About 900 of them are scattered across the island, with an average height of 13 feet, or 4 meters, almost half of which were located in the Ranarawaku Stone Quarry. People don't realize that it's not just the heads that are there, but entire bodies. Some believe that the Polynesian people built the statues with the belief that they reversed the damage of leprosy that had plagued the island. Whether they were effective or not, your guess is as good as ours.